All right, so now let's jump in and let's look at this other record that we're gonna use. This one's called Imagino. I'm gonna pull it on the deck. And actually, before we do that, I'm gonna change the view that we're looking at. So if you see in our top left-hand corner here, we see, oh, you can't really see that. Hold on, let me show you this. There it is. It's two decks horizontal. I'm gonna drop this down to prepare. Okay, so prepare is now just giving me only one deck. And this is a great mode to be able to get your hot cues right, to edit your grid, which we're gonna talk about here in a moment. This is a great mode to just be focused and not see the mixer, not see the other track, just really zero in on what you're trying to do here. So here we go. I'm gonna go ahead and start mapping. 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 1. This is our intro. And this is all instrumental, which is great. Very useful. 2, 3, 4, and 1. 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 1. Now, I think this is the verse. I'm still not really quite sure. So this, I'm just listening. 1. This feels like it's coming up, and it also, he's saying Imagino. So this is giving me some sort of an indicator that something's happening. One, this is our drop. And one, two, three, four, two, three, four, one, two, three. This is it, back to the verse. There's a lot of clues in the music. You can hear the different phrases. Right, you can almost feel it. There we go. This is the same as this. And when I say that, I mean it's the same section, and the lyrics are the same. Even if you don't understand Spanish, which I don't. One, or not much of it, actually. And I gave you this on purpose so that we could focus on the music and not necessarily the what the lyrics are saying. Same thing. And notice these are the same too. One. Back to the drop. You're starting to see the patterns, right? One. And one, two, three, four, two, two, three, four, one. Another turn here. One. This is our bridge. Two, Okay, so this little section, I'm actually gonna put this. That's like our outro, and that has like horns on it, which is cool. This little section that I marked off here, I'm not exactly sure. I think I might have missed something here, so I'm gonna go back and double check that. But the rest of it is here, and now I'm gonna go ahead and convert this into bars, because right now it's in phrases. So this is 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 4, 8, 8, 8 with a 2 here, right? This little turn. This was 8 plus 4, but I think I might have missed something here. And then this was 8, 8, 8, and a 4, right? So what I wanted to show you here was that, like, yes, there's some patterns, but it's also not the exact same all the way through. Like, this isn't just 8 bar sections all the way through. Like, we've got some changes that are here. So now what we need to do is, like, what are the parts that are of interest to us, right? Like, where would we get out of this? I would get out of it here. Right, like after the drop, same thing here, after the drop, or maybe I would use the same turn. This was like Stranger, same sort of a thing. Maybe I would use the bridge, but I need to make sure I figure that part of it out. And then maybe this last drop or this like outro here, right? These are the sections that are of interest in terms of places to get out. I'm not gonna get out, so the drop, let's talk about this a little bit. Drop in electronic dance music is sort of the same thing as our chorus. It's the part that people are anticipating, which basically means that I cannot change the song before the drop hits. I need to wait for the drop to hit. So I'm not gonna mix out here because that's before the drop, right? Like that's a big no. This is a big no, I don't wanna do that. I wanna make sure that I'm mixing out after the drop right there. Now, with electronic dance music, there is something else that we can get into later, which is called a drop swap. And I can, instead of playing this drop, I can change the record over and play another drop. But what I don't want to do is have this thing naturally build and then it doesn't go anywhere, right? Like, I don't want to change it before it gets to its peak. So this is a good focus point. And then in terms of our intro here, we've got an 8-bar intro. Solid. Okay, so the reason also why I wanted to highlight this part here that I was telling you about is I want to go back and double check that, which I also want to let you guys know it's okay if you don't get this right on the first shot. Like if you just only get part of it and then you get lost and you need to go back to it, that's perfectly fine. I mean, that happens to me. You even see this happens to me. And I actually even helped produce this record. So, you know, I think going back and double checking your work is super helpful. So let's just, let me do that real quick. So this was 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 4, 1. 2, 3. 4, 2, 3, 4, 1. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Yeah. So there's this little 2-beat section, which is technically half of a bar. It's this like 2-beat section that happens right there. Now, I need to know that if I'm going to use the bridge to mix out, because if I'm gonna use the bridge to mix out here, I need to keep this in mind, that might actually throw me off potentially. Now, why is that even there? Well, this is helping our ear keep things interesting. Right? And so a lot of producers will add in these types of turns, especially in electronic dance music, you'll hear these types of turns. So you just need to figure them out and understand them. When I first started DJing, I was scared of sections like that. It would throw me off and I'd have no idea how to mix around it. And now when you start to break it down, you can sort of see where that is. So remember that the one is where the change is. You can feel this. In fact, actually, let me go back just a little bit so you can feel it. One, right? So you can feel where that one is. And so that ultimately is where the one is where the section changes. You just don't keep counting straight through. So with little things that you might find like that, just take a moment to go back and just check your work to make sure that that's correct. All right, we're gonna shift gears real quick. I'm gonna hit pause on this. Make sure that you, or you can go ahead and hit pause on this too. Make sure that you have digested what we just mapped out. Double check your work, come right back, and we're gonna get into editing the grid.